Back to my last play of the Great Ace Attorney Chronicles. Now, last time we just started chapter 2, and now we are about to continue. Now, before I start chapter on the next part, I do want to say something. I've noticed something in comments looks like to links or something. Guys, can you please not do that? It's going to be flagged as spam. And my comments on my YouTube videos. Just say what you're about to say on there, please, because, one, I cannot respond, and two, I do want to get one other thing out of the way. That whole debacle with Akio Saper, it's over with, guys. But he just literally just, like, he was being a troll, and if you watched my video on the Project Overlord video with Mass Effect 2, I think it was part 11, I think it was. 11 or 12. Well, he even apologized to that. So guys, that includes the person known as Let's Be Honest here. If that's you, Akio, or should I say random game Sony gamer, please stop. Guys, I can talk. I'm the kind of person who's willing to talk in the comments and all that stuff. I'm a nice guy. Just, guys, please. No spamming of that type of stuff. Or spamming of whatever, .fyi, is being posted on the thing. I also read in the review there is going to be some, how you put it, racial slurs in this, in an upcoming, part, in an upcoming chapter. I am not going to repeat any of this line of, said lines, because I really don't know what would be known as that. I may be American, but I am not that. I am beneath that BS. I don't care if it is old school European, old school British on it. So please, guys, just stop with that. Stop with the whole random spamming of my YouTube comments with stuff that, one, has no link, and two, is really just kind of making me uncomfortable. I mentioned before I have high anxiety and high blood pressure. I really don't need this stuff, guys. Please. With that said, let's get going. Time for part two of this investigation. It looks like there's like two or three parts, three or four parts to each chapter. It looks like so. Once part two's done, I will go. I'll probably do part three, depending how long it is later. Ninth January, SS Beru, first class cabin passageway. Oh, of course. I wish I hadn't been thrown out like that. I wish we managed to find some clues what that speckled band might be. We didn't manage to investigate at all. And I imagine that we won't be able for a while longer. We'll never get past the sailor guarding that door. He's glaring at us as if we don't even think about it. Oh, wait a minute. What is it? Well, what happened to the great detective friend? Where'd he go? Oh yes, he's completely disappeared. When did he do that? Oh, of course. He slipped away quite quickly as a wind, not before ensuring these were securely back on my wrist. Oh, of course. Back to here. think there's nothing really much to see. SS Beret, first class cabin, number one. Looks like they're still missing in here. Yes, on that subject. One of the special housing units is unscathed. You mean unscathed? Certainly you haven't forgotten, have you, Naboro-san? Don't you remember what he said about allowing you in the cabin, out of this cabin to investigate? He was going to the captain about it. He said he lay his life on the line for you. Oh, yes. I think that's him over there. I'm sure he was exaggerating. Let's see how he has to save himself. He might have some information for us. You never know. Now, clearly the letter's written in the ink, with the as somehow spilt on the floor. And they spell Russian word for wardrobe. It seems ambiguous pointer to the modern sun as you were sleeping in there. But it's true and ambiguous. It would have to spell out the name you know that don't you think? My name, don't you think? Well, either way, on the lack of means. It's hard to imagine Kazuma would have had his last words written in Russian. But a large question, who did write it? Ew, where did you go? Oh, sorry. I just went out. I just wanted to go. Hi. Oh, it's back there. Oh, it's not there. That new Japanese, was it? Later, I will roll him in a ball and throw him off the cold in the cold. Oh, of course. Ooh, he's gone back to guarding the door. I hope the special house of Nagi doesn't find himself too much trouble on his account. He's really gone on his way to help, isn't he? When we get back to Japan, we have to take him for the steak a little for Kotoba. That could be a very long time from now in Barcelona. There he is. Oof! You're back. Okay, Inspector. What happened to you? Your face is... Please don't worry about it. They're just scratches. Scratches? Made by a bear, maybe. I told the captain he told me that he pummeled me fishing and tossed me. What? But the pummel was over in a flash. He must have decided against throwing overboard. So it was nothing really. It looks like he wasn't joking when he said he laid his life on the line that he had to. Well, thank you for your effort. To your efforts, we know little about our neighbor account. Yes, so I understand. Oh. I bumped into the man claiming to be the great detective a little while ago. I think his name was something like Sherlock Holmes. I don't think he was German though. Yeah, that explains it. Shall we compare notes in? Can you tell what you found? Ah, yes, let's do it. Captain next door. What? They're coming up on a long spot. She's in the next circuit. Oh, don't you know who she is? Hey, what's up, respecting ballet fan? What? Well, that sums up his wife in a nutshell. Oops, I think that's up there. Well, tell us the neighboring cabin is. Well, that tells. Oh, how? Because angels don't go around committing crimes to them. Oops. Damn, I definitely upset him. Oof. Inspector, has your investigation proved fruitful? I'm honest, there's very little I can do. Our duty is to make sure the CS agents are ready to hand over to the Hong Kong police. Hong Kong, oh boy. Just keeping a watch. So I'm keeping a watch or trying not to take my eye off the dog. Oh, I see. Ah, there's one thing. I have a small piece of information for you. Oh, what? Yes, tell us, Inspector, please. New information. What's this new information you have, Inspector? This is this. The medical report. It was probably, I managed to obtain the report. Oh, it's Kazuma's postmortem report. Kazuma's not. So, what's the cause of death? Damage to the cervical vertebrae is written on the report. So he was broken. His neck was snapped. His neck was broken. Yes, it would seem so. There's no obvious wounds or signs of injury. I think they were. So first, I was thinking they were considering poison. But it turns out they found no traces of poison in the system at all. Well, what's the weapon they used then? I think it's the sword. Nothing has been found yet. But in fact, there's no signs of a wound, suggesting that must have been a blunt object. That's something that would have left a little more. Oh, I see. I think I know what it is. Wound would be left. I know what it is, just by the way of hearing that. It might be useful. You're welcome to have it. Really? Are you sure? Yes, it's fine. I trust you. After all, I didn't trust you. If I didn't trust you, I never agreed to leaving the cavern. Just a thought. Great detective. Oh, Mr. Sholmes. Was here, was he? Yes, he seemed to be enjoying himself a little too much as he crept about on the floor investigating. Of course. Then he suddenly left. Did he say anything at all? Actually, now you mention it, there's one thing. That's just one thing. He particularly shouted. It's shoe polish. That's what he said. Shoe polish. Oh! It was when he was over at the bar. Now I get it. Do you see it? Yeah, I see. I was talking about the brick-covered mark. Do you think? Ah, yes. Must be. It. Now, how could Mr. Sholmes know a shoe polish? That leaves me cold. I'm afraid I have no idea. What's it? What is it, Sartori-san? Well, C- Kuma-san was wearing leather shoes with a very dark tan hue. Dark tan. A sort of dark tan, dark brownish. It's red then. Yes, a little red color vine, but darker. I often repaired it from. Oh, does this mean this mark that made by the paws as soon as they scuffed on the floor? That's really all I can tell you at this stage. I should return to my pose. My fellow groomman's eyes are boring into my back already. You might be for the best. Thank you. Poor his back. You look exhausted. Oh, no. Well, I feel terrible that I failed to protect Asagi-san. He was my responsibility. Of course, my pain is nothing compared to yours. You are his friends. Truth is, I seem to have a heavy head ever since I woke up this morning. A heavy head? That's interesting. My head's still throbbing too. This is where Kusuma spent his final moments writing his diary. I can hear a faint whistling sound. What looks like a sword or a speckling band dangling from the ventilation riddles. Looks like, at looking at his writing here on this page, it's almost impossible to believe that he's gone. Kusuma-san left a vulnerable clue in these words, I'm sure of it. We have to solve the mystery, Baro-san. We will. Yes, that's right. And just a few months before he died, Kusuma-san saw something dangling from a spectacle band, as he described it. If only Miss Parvon was able to shed light on it, but she seems baffled as we are. Yes, I wonder if she's telling us everything, though. Oh, I'm not sure. I know most people are bored. Would say the same thing about me, but there's something about that woman that didn't sit right with me. Yeah, there is something different odd about her. It's really such a beautiful glass color of glass. It looks like whatever it has was broken clean in two. But on the other half, the other half is nowhere to be seen. And that's where the color mark is. With shoe polish, according to the great detective, you seem to know all about. I saw this. It must be from Kazuma's shoes. Maybe, but I'd like to know is, how can the detective be sure of shoe polish and not something else? Because he's a great detective, of course. That's hardly a reason, isn't it? Is it? W- When I went for help, I forced down the door. The bolt has something firmly... have been firmly closed. It's quite a small bolt. And no particular sturdy. And just side of slid across the door shut. But still, the door bolted, there would be no way to get in or out the cabin for sure. This game reminds me. It is. Before I continue, Random 70 Gamer, this is actually a prequel, if you're familiar with it, of the Ace Attorney franchise. Actually, this is the Great Ace Detective, the prequel that came out for it that over here in the States never got, and not sure on your end, and over in England, and that came out back in 2013, I think it was, and the sequel that came out in 2017 that were both on the 3DS, but never came out into the States, I guess copyright reasons or whatever the reason, it was never discussed, to be honest. It was like similar situation with Investigations 2 for Miles Edward. But I think it was because of more of how poorly the first game sold poorly, but I don't know. This is also both on the Switch and the PS4, which I'm playing on. And I know it's on Steam, and I don't have a Steam account, so. It's no wonder anyone's. No wonder everyone suspects me. Oh boy. When it glares at me, I feel it tense up and down my spine. I remember reading. Once in a detective's novel, that a culprit used a needle to thread the bolt. Yeah, but that's not gonna work here. Also, Random Filming Gamer, are you the guy who keeps randomly posting comments on my videos? Because if so, can you please stop? That's a clever trick, isn't it? I've never read or detective stories myself. But the door of this cabinet and its frame are made of meals, and they're sealed together perfectly. Okay, Robert Phil. No, I promise. Really? Okay, the person, Robert Phillips, can you please stop? I know some people are starting to, do this. I'm asking nicely to a lot of people, please stop doing this. Because, one, it's coming up as spam on my video, and two, it's really hard for me to interact with everybody. Can you all please stop that, please? I appreciate any comments on my videos, but please stop. Oh boy. No, because they technically aren't, because they're all different people, and to be honest, I rarely block. I know you're gonna quote me on comment on me on that, but like random comments like that is not gonna worthy of block of being blocked. almost certain whatever it is inside the traveling case in their cabin. A friend. There's more to this than it seems, I think. A book provided by the passenger he really nearly arranged on the shelf. Oh. A place to learn, look. Well, anyway, I feel much better than the only one. Enough of the sun. Samus is gone. Strange enough. The brutally wretched sailor who always crossing his arms is glaring at us. Ugh. I'm not gonna say that. Tra-la-la. Did you hear that? It sounded like someone singing. La 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 la. The Greek detective's way. Of course. This caroling. I know that lark like voice. Yep, it's Mr. Detective himself. This is a golden opportunity. Well, never mind that now. This is a golden opportunity for us. Yes, you're right. We must seize it. Look inside Miss Paul's cabin while we can investigate. Definitely. Before that. I'm not gonna say that. Alright. Even I have hard trouble pronouncing names. Names. January. And of course, whatever's inside is gone. Gone. Oh, where's he gone? Hey, what are you doing? Hey, those are private things. There's not a moment of waste, Naruto-san. We must investigate quickly as we can. I suppose you're right. For Kazuma's sake. Not just for Kazuma, son. What do you mean? For you, of course. A port, Hong Kong. In Hong Kong. I don't want you to be in those handcuffs when we get there. Really? We must solve this case, Naruto-san, by ourselves. We have a lot to do. Yes, we will. Let's go. Oh boy. Oh my, Miss Barbara's case is open. It's completely empty side, but according to the great detective, deduction, she was hiding her special friend in there. Yes, a friend that she kept secret. But we're not allowed to bring animals aboard the SS Beruya. I can't even pronounce that. I wonder what kind of animals she had in there. And more to the point, where is it now? The cabin door has a simple bolt latch to it that our cabinet door has. The bolt drawn across, there's no way anybody could enter the cabinet from the outside. Yes, it's not particularly heavy bolt either. In particularly heavy bolt, is it? But still, I wonder when it's like cross on its own, would it? No. The door is made of metal. There's no chance of trickery using magnets or on bolt from the outside. And if it's sealed up perfectly too, there's to stop any seawater coming in. And you couldn't use the method you told me about passing through a thread through the crack around the closed door either. It seems I know a lot of tricks for opening doors. I'm starting to see why they suspect me. I see that too. Hello. I wonder what was this little saucer doing on the floor? Yet it doesn't look like it's been dropped. More like it was put there deliberately. Do you think there could be a leak in the roof above here? What leak? It's a ship. Not. It's quite safe. I'm sure not even a little leak on the roof. It doesn't mean the whole ship's gonna sink. No, you're wrong. Of course you're right. She's really trying to persuade herself, isn't she? Yeah. Messy tea set, though. Well, it seems this teapot is empty. Natural course conclusion is that the Russians are very thirsty people. Wow. Or, because Ms. Pavlova, I can't even pronounce these last names. Pavlova. Can you tell me what? I'm also thinking about, I have never played this game, Random Sony Gamer. This is a very blind let's play, so I have never played this game before. This serious game. All I can tell is it's like one of those. This franchise is basically a visual novel. Well, visual novel, court-like case. But right now, we're investigating right now. I mean, it could be either B. It definitely... There's... Alright. Look up Phoenix Wright. Right. Phoenix Wright franchise. That's the best way to describe it. But I might do a let's play on that on here. I'm not sure. It'd definitely be exclusively thirsty in that. You're rather off taint, aren't you, Naruto-san? Naruto-san. I think I really am not getting even try with these names. names, they're really hard to pronounce. There's just a few books on this, nothing else by the looks of it. Well, Miss Barbalone only ran away from the ballet last night. She hardly occupied this cabin for any time at all. True. That's true. I wonder what kind of book she likes to read. Let me see. Yes, I see. It seems like Miss Barbalone enjoys reading. You don't say. Books written in Russian. Of course. Thank you, thanks. I probably already knew that. It's rude to ask such too much for people in our son. Kindly remember that. True. Hello. I thought it was this every cabin's waste basket. Shall we have a little look? See what's been thrown away anyway? Now the son. It's more than I can decipherly from someone's bubble. Oh, it's, you know. Ugh, those eyes. She looks at me like I'm a piece of rubbish now. However, there are special circumstances, I think. Exactly. We have no choice. There's hardly anything in here at all. Oh, well, that's a little disappointing. And of course, all these books topple over, look, every single one. Do you think it's good to see, perhaps, the god of the sea, he's toppling them too? Well, it's exactly the same as the bookcase. It's next door, in Kazuma's cavern. Perhaps Miss Polo was seeing this guy, a difficult ballet to pose the bill against the bookcase. I don't know. She would be practicing ballet on the same night she ran away from the ballet. She did say the fact that she wants to get away from it. Alright then. It must have been you who lost your time. Oh, come on, not everything has bad happens on ship just because of me, you know? It has to be turbulent, the waves. Let me write down right here again, too. I don't think seeing anything in this array. All the books provided the passenger officer now neatly arranged on the shelf. Thus, it's very unthinkable to dance around inside the cabin. Tell that to Miss Promotion, Pavavola, not me. Anyway, I much feel much better now that they're neatly lined up. I can relax when things are untidy. No comment. Ah, yes. They are displayed in this cabinet. They look... I guess... A passage. Passengers must not keep weapons or any dangerous objects in their cabinet. Pets are strictly forbidden. I suppose Miss Pavavola realized that she needs to keep the contents of her case a secret when she read this. Our special friend, I mean. I wonder where her friend has been disappeared to now. Okay, I haven't explored the ship, I imagine. I hope some seaman Stroganov doesn't find out and throw it overboard. Oh yes, so do I. Now, brother's son, are you there? You sorry? I'm right here, I guess. Why? Oh, good. I thought you might have climbed into the wardrobe when I wasn't looking. There's some place that looks like home. Believe me, I don't have some strange compulsion to jump inside every wardrobe I see, you know? Well, anyway, I'm not sure anyone could fit inside this one. It's full of beautiful outfits. I suppose they're all stage costumes. I was rather hoping we might find Miss Popovola's friend hiding in there, but no such luck. There's one of these bells consumers coming too. Yes, it's bell cord. I can't resist. Ugh, you had to do that. She barely hesitated there and gave a good tug to. No, I didn't exactly expect anyone to come. You'll have to want them to. We're trying to investigate a secret. Is there anything else? Is there anything else we need to examine before we leave? There's a vent. So this ventilation connection to the Kazuma's cabin next door. Yes, although what fool of a ship builder must be open a ventilation into another room. Maybe. It's so that the gas leak next door when the occupant in the cabin would notice and raise the alarm. Or the occupants both climb on the cabin full of die of a gas poisoning. That is a possibility. Anyway, last night, Kazuma wrote and saw a spectral band coming out of the ventilation. Looks like that's all I can find in here. Guess there is something so left in there. I'm not gonna look it up, cause as anything else. Wait, that bell. Be something I'm missing in here. Ah, there he is.
Well, Mr. Shums, look. You never know who's going to turn up next, Nick, do you? He seems to be stealing a look at something he signs himself. As he sings himself. I did it the great detective way. He's still singing. Do you think he's even noticed us? Or is simply extremely high spirit? As there were times, I'm sure you know, when the yard bit off more than it could chew. And though it's lucky Herlock was about. Oh boy. Excuse me. I saw it all and I stood tall. I did the great detective way. Mr. Sherlock. I thought you were never gonna stop. I thought I figured it. I never dropped you on the floor with one of my famous fight up. Alright, I get it, the picture. Can you put the fist away? This guy is alright. Mr. Sholmes, you seem to be examining something before we interrupt you. Ah, yes, that. I was immersed in the study of the ship's logs, as penned by the stockily built crewman, who's usually on guard here. Oh, the ship's log. The ship's log. And did you find anything useful from it? Well, after 2 a.m. in the morning, majority of the entirety of its entries is blank. Well, that's an understatement, which means there was nothing to report. Nothing to happen, so. You truly are a student from the land of the rising sun. You utterly blind by it, huh? Sorry. Your logic, my boy, is inverted. What do you mean by it, Mr. Solms? Absorb the other page. Yes. Shall become clear. It would seem the crewman stands sentry in the first class passageway. And he has most religious practice of recording nothing but a port every half hour. That is weird. Oh, he writes that every 30 minutes? That is weird. Nothing to report. Precisely put, simply, writes nothing to report when there's just that. And yet, the ship's log from last night is largely blank. He didn't even write nothing to report. Okay, that is weird. Do you mean? Yes, there's some circumstances afoot last night, which means the seaman has been absent from his post. What kind of circumstances? What happened? That remains a mystery for now, but we are sure something significant took place. So significant it caused the seaman to forget his regular habits of scribbling nothing to report in the log. Those are important details. I will stake my life on it. You must log the ship's log in your mental file. Interesting. Now that deduction is worthy of a great detective. Was worthy of the great of a great. Ah, you're starting to understand my way, I see. What makes Sharm's soul I'm sorry, this guy, I don't know what about this guy, but, yeah. Oh, ow. What are you hurt? Oh, don't worry about yourself. I've seen the effect of the throbbing head this morning. Some reason, nothing more. Well, my friends, until our next encounter. He's still singing to himself. I can hear him wandering down the path. That throbbing head has something to do with something. Is something wrong? So I tossed it on. It's not just him. I'm noticing it too. Everybody's having it. It's just, well, I feel the same. Sorry? Ever since I woke up this morning, I've had something of a headache. It has to do with something with the ship, doesn't it? What happened last night, ship-wise. It has to be. I have to think about it. A sort of continuous throbbing. Oh, you too? What's that? Shut down the engines immediately. The vessel is sighted in the corner of mile 4. Full stop. Hard starboard. Hands on brace on deck for impact. What the? I think we're about to crash into another ship. What? I can't stand. So that was not. Hold on a sec. Are you alright? Are you in the middle? I think I'm fine. Thank you, Naruto-san. I think we found out what caused the headache. Like we avoided a collision. I think, yes, the ship has come to a stop. Oh my goodness, what about Naruto-san? You brought us, are you hurt? No, I'm fine. Hello, I said, am I there? Shout if you can guess. Oh, that sounds like. It's back to Austin, I know. I said. Oh, quickly. What the? The door bolt. Oh! That's how it did it! The door is bolted. Did you see that? No, I didn't touch it. Well, that's strange. How did... And... There we go! There's the mystery! They're just like they were before, again. Now, Rosan, are you getting to open the door and let the inspector in? I better tidy up the place first. Alright. Stop has stopped the mystery. Solved one mystery at least, in a very tidy way. But I knew what awaited for us on the other side of the door. Cabin would not be pleasant. I heard around tidying up the cabin in a new sense of forbidding heart. You know what? Let's finish this case, cause I have time. Yeah, let's save. Again, to everybody who keeps posting random comments in my thing, I mean, please, I beg you to stop. It's. Again, it's really annoying. I don't mind the comments. Trust me. But I could. If I need to make sense, please. So, Somehow the door in the cabin were ended up bolted and we made an emergency stop. So all of a sudden, deep took a breath and gently slid back the bolt. Oh boy. You, what are you doing with... Are you both unhurt? Good. Yes, we're fine. Thank you. What else happened? We heard anything about collide with another ship. Yes, it appears to have been a false report though. Oh, how did that happen? There is a dense fog outside and extremely difficult to see. Someone must have thought there was a ship ahead. Everything is chaos. Passengers are screaming and crew is everywhere. The first class area is the only quarter of the ship at the moment. Oh, I see. Somehow, someone triggered the alarm. Does that mean that someone pressed the button outside? Oh, you were an intruder. Sorry, me. I've been called a lot of things before. But the devil is the first. You opened my Oh, I didn't even touch it. That's right, Miss Polavola. It was already open when we came into your cabin. Inspector. Yes. Arrest this man. I know he's a criminal. It's enough that he... No, it's all away. Take him away. He's... So annoying. Don't worry, Bessie's right. You are... It doesn't look good. There's a cell. Tomorrow the dock in Hong Kong. In that case. Wait, the cell? First of all, is there nothing you can do? The Russian vessel. This is the Russian vessel. We have no jurisdiction here. I have nothing. It's after my last of court of federal appeal, I am not. This is terrible. This is a real crisis. I have to find some solution. Immediately. You've got yourself into a difficult situation. Find the cabin, don't invite me. Sorry, I was just desperate to find a clue. Where there's really nothing more I really can help you. I push my luck further, or a punch in the face will be less than my words. I'm really sorry. I have to take responsibility giving you the freedom to investigate my problem with the cabin. Now this happened, I might have to report to the cabin at once. I really need something, someone to help here. I need a saver to rescue me in the crisis. Of course. There he is. What the? What are you doing up there? Mr. Holmes? Naturally, I was analyzing the weight of the $20,000 ruby. Really? Have I not told you that as a detective, it's my business to find other people? Do not. There. Is it obvious? Probably it's the weight of the 10,000. That's early. I wish to determine if that's been conceded off the hook of the full bag of bounce. Again, I've never whether to take this man seriously or not. You again. The great detective. Inspector. I confess. Yes, I've been looking for you. I have something to report to you most urgently. Well, you might try looking for somewhere other than a hook on the wall next time. What was this report? Speak. An urgent report from the great detective. From the great detective meant one thing. Yes. The case of the curious murder took place last night. of the same Arborea has been solved by me naturally. Huh? What? Really? As I eliminated all possibilities, there's no request. So allow me to eliminate your mind all in mind. I'm not about to reveal the great detectives greatly absurd great deduction to this case. So you've solved it? Even Hedgehog understand this case. We all know responsible for killing the civilian was more and we found that criminal in the car. It's a silhouette. I didn't do it. The trouble is, there doesn't appear to be anyone else that killed him. And the cabin is bolted shut inside. And that means the culprit must have something. Yes, that's what's called the locked room mystery in the detective story. The locked room point, that's the point. There's a room, it's locked. What's locked? Well, I can't deny that. There was no way the bolt could have drawn across the room. You're quite mistaken, you're wrong. The cabin next door was not so-called a locked room at all. What? Oh yes, there's another entrance. Yeah, the entrance last night, the culprit was gaining access on the other entrance. What other entrance? Why? Gas, open mouth, you're gonna speak as we speak. The ventilation, man. The ventilator! Huh. I can't even pull my arm off of that hole. That's because your arm is as thick as a tree trunk. You're suggesting the culprit entered or left the victims of finding the opening? That's not possible. But it is. Last night, the victim was the intruder actually passing the ventilator. Mr. Solms, do you mean... You're referring to the words Kazuma wrote in his diary? I can hear a faint whistling sound. And what seems like a speckled band dangling from the ventilator ground. Precisely, my dear Manum. But what does it mean? What's the speckle? After that particular phenomenon, is the very cabin. Is in this very cabin. Mr. Sean, what are you doing? The distance elementary danger is fair not. I'm ready. I'll shock the car. Oh. Oh. What the? Allow me to introduce you to all to the band, the spectacle band. A snake, an odd ability. Mr. Sholmes, just one thing. Well, that snake, is it really speckled? Is it really? Even more stripy, wouldn't you say? Yes, you're right. There's a thing you have to call it. You call it? The stripped band, wouldn't you say? Right, band. You both see and observe with this distinction, however. Do you not think that the precise trap into which the culprit wishes you to fall? Goodness, really? It's a trap. I think perhaps it's time I explain the intricacies of my thought. Are you ready, Miss Palavola? I'm sorry for the young man who died, but that is all. This death has nothing to do with me. The whole thing has nothing to do with me. There's two conclusions I've drawn from the fact no one Last night, your friend invited the victim's cabin. Ah. And number two, the same friend was responsible for the poison. No. She's turned white as a ball is rising again. Solomon might be right. He hit the nail on the head. That young woman's friend killed Mr. Son. Looks like he can't speak with the snake coil around his head. I would advise a little moment, please, as possible, Seaman. You wouldn't want that fangs of your friend, your long friend, in your neck. So everyone, let's begin. So Sherlock Holmes perhaps presents a logic and reasoning speculation. Here we go. So how many of this? He said two. The intruder's identity. As for a moment ago, you claimed the following. The death has nothing to do with me. The whole thing has nothing to do with me. You cannot deceive yourself. And when you recall the horrid event, your echoed hearts, aching hearts, will point. And the very pain, that evidence inexcusable the victim's death. So we ask, what nature is the intruder's soul purportedness might proton with the night-night? Why, naturally, it was a friend which you brought it the vessel, is it not? As I expected, and yet another telltale glance. It's not to that, I can tell. Yet, the fact that leaves a quandary. The victim's observations question is Feckle Van. Hell is Van. Regardably, the specimens are not a description anyway. Oh boy. What explanation can we give to pray that this is now upon the victim's eyes late at night? Oh, that, don't look at me. I just don't enjoy any of this. Oh, but it does. The answer to this quandary is hidden behind your back. Shed it, little skin, no. I didn't know what you were talking. Right, though, the ventilation cabinet, your speckle. Hi. A snake is so dreadful. Okay, a beloved speckled snake. How Miss Arsagi died. Moving on, we come to the matter of the grim demise of the victim. How did the young man lose his life, and why? According to the deck, which I've been praised, it would appear no visible sign of injury. Oh. In fact, the circumstances of the victim's death can only be attended with a terrible venom, by a terrible venom. By a fact, if they take that as a fact, you can only reasonably imagine the revelations affirmed than the scene of the crime. Or not, there can't be. As examined by the seized of body, proves the cause of death is almost not quite impeccable puncture wound to the left, left by the venomous fang seal the truth. The vestiges of snake bite delivered by your terrible friend. This makes no sense. There is no point of fringing even as possible, but after an innocent or the innocent, you endeavor to danger not hide everything. But now you're involved in betrayed hiding place these shoes. That's right, you hide evidence to link your. Whether we need the first cabin, it came to my attention your case moved periodically. Your serpent. This guy. No, you don't. It's telling them the. The train. Sorry, I really can't speak at the moment. You couldn't know the animal had done its duty, so you listened for signs of the. Do you deny the snake is undergoing such thing? It's not true. Having slithered through the ventilation bell, the cord only needed to sink his veins once. And the venom coursed through the victim's veins, and it, of course. Oh boy. There's no doubt. No. Yeah, but there is some flaws to it. Alright, let's time this. Yeah, there's a problem with it. Their faces summoned all up. I was following the train. Is there a sauce of milk? Well, that's the food I'm asking. In the kettle, you solved the mystery. Amazing, you agreed to do this. But there are some flaws in here, man. I could have done the left one line. Can we venture in on a painting, Mr. Solms? Well, of course. What is on your mind? It's just about your deduction for. Something doesn't quite make sense to me. I welcome questions and to my method to help the answer probably. Oh, well, good. First of all, snakes are laying egg creatures, part of a tablet tile family. Yeah? Are well informed, I know. And reptiles, don't drink milk. It's only mammals that drink milk, you see. I'm sure it's possible to train a snake using milk as a reward. No matter. No doubt we'll fall alone. It's not some treat occurring. Well, there is something else. Snake has no ears. Yes, I'm sure it's really possible to signal a snake whistle. But now, what tells? What does it tell from a radio? Have you heard of the dance of the flutist? I think perhaps performing player's music at times needs natural movements. Oh, I see. hands, no feet, no ears. Those creatures are inept and practically useless. Don't take it out on the snakes, Mr. Solms. There's one other thing. One more thing. Snakes are scales. Use scales on their belly to propel themselves. So, it's not really sure the snake could manage to climb up on the flat belly of the cord once the cap on these cap. Then I should try harder. Please don't be angry with me, Solms. The point is, You have to think, had gone through the ventilation the next door, it couldn't have been come back for the help. What I'm trying to say is, it's served a number of reasons why it's difficult to imagine that the snake could have had part in this. Huh. Yeah, but there's one problem with that. I think we need to step in again and help us again. Oh no, you don't mean. Yes, we need to modify method statement. The adoption turned to great. I had a feeling it was coming. Alright, let's give it a try. Well, that I was waiting for. That's an order. Yes, right. So let's cast an eye on this again. Okay. Here we go again. We're done again. They don't know. Why did he know? Or now, Delcy. I really wish that you leave him off. Now, everybody, let's begin. Sherlock Holmes is brilliant, logic and reasoning spectacular. There. Mr. Holmes, with my beloved speckled steak. Yes. She does have a pained expression on her face. Yes, that's true. She looks like she, as someone said, is weighing heavily on her mind. But you're not sure Mr. Sholmes read her quite correctly. That is, could there be some way to interpret her expression? Take a moment. Let's take a moment. Really look very closely at Miss Purple. Here we go. Oh, that's a look. It's only two. Well, whatever the scratch doesn't appear to be around here. Found it. Yes, you recall the horror bit that classroom. Indeed, its simple observation reveals that the wound is fresh. Miss Farvon, do you in fact receive a scratch? In fact, it is. Sometime last night. Ah. When I think about the young man who died next door, I feel so sad. When I'm sad, I pain from wounds. The wound is worse. And it's a very painful evidence that it grasps directly the victim's death. So I ask, what's the nature of this intruder's soul's victim? What naturally is a friend? Is it not? Ah, that's suspected. There we go. It seems like the scratch marks on the back of the Provost's hand was made by a friend of hers, doesn't it? Except, the snake doesn't have claws, do they? No, they don't. They don't even have hands or feet without claws might grow. Well then, if that snake isn't her pet, then what is her parents' true identity of hers? We should follow her gaze down. There we go.
Yes.
Oh. I'll try it again. Ah, oh, look at the photograph in the frame. This must be something much more about bought. I would say, run away. She's especially beautiful, isn't she? The cat!
Yes!
I doubt your friend is the little kid that we've seen before. Yes, the scratch on the back of your hand makes him look clear. Oh no. Whereabouts the black kid isn't clear, but it is clear. Is that the vaulting animal when you ran away, didn't ya? No. Darka is my best friend. I can't leave her with my what appear to be a Russian blue. And yet the fact of leaves is a quite is in a quandary. The victim regardless. The fact of specimen did not find the description in the way. That's giving us the game. Hey, what was this? Oh, do you have an answer to the quandary here? Yes, that's concealed. There we go. She mentioned about the cat. Do you see that? Just like something out of her pocket had hid out behind her sack. If she had left in her pocket, no one had ever had known. Oh yes, Floy, Mr. Sholmes, particularly, he's ever clever forced to reveal something. I thought that the deduction was his speciality. Or maybe making me believe that it's a ploy too. Anyway, I find it hard to believe that sneakskin. In that case, this was Mass Pavilion hiding behind her back. Well, isn't that sparkled? What? It seems soft and fluffy. A long piece of cloth of some sort? And a cat's toy? Wait. In some sort of West, apparently. That's his how is that a cat toy for cats? Cats chase Rand. You need to wave it around. Ah. Yes, the thing is truly falling to conceal a cat's toy. Precisely, a true nature of a speckled, famous fangled man. Ah! A toy dangling through the ventilation. The way that pursued, naturally, the victim couldn't fall veil unnoticed. But why? For what reason? My boy can only be the answer to that. He's feeling, after feeling his peer, the ventilation, the neighbor, was well attempted to use the special cat toy to kick inside. Summary, the nature of the friend Miss Pavola was last night was seen in the crime. A wrestling cat named Dark. It's really troublesome feeling Darka is proven to be. She must be caged once found. You will forgive us for borrowing the photograph of your pet, your Miss Barbara. It was after I gave her food last night. That's when it happened. She scratched the back of my hand and ran up the bell cord. Before I could do anything, she had disappeared through the ventilator. Darka, she's so naughty. Now they'll finally pull the case in case of this. Now we can prove it differently. Moving on, we came to hear the heart of the matter, the grim demise of our victim. How did the young man lose his life, and why? According to the data, his prize has been appraised, assigned no physical sign of injury. In fact, there are circumstances of the victim's death could only be. Yeah, that's good. Nope. There were no signs of a wound anywhere on Kazuma's body. That's right. But Nasolms is unaware of the important detail. Kazuma wasn't poisoned. Yes, it would seem so. Let's give another information missing now. In fact, the circumstances of the victim's death can only be explained in the party course. Yes, I knew that it was one or the other. His neck was snap, indeed, the breaking of the cervical. Only that Goliath was strong. Seemingly strong isn't I'm freaking out. There he is out. Anyway, we have a good authority that the victim's neck was broken. Now, we're taking the fact that as that we can reasonably imagine the remains evidence of the scene of the crime. Oh no, there couldn't be. Yes, the examination of the deceased body will prove. Kazuma died because his neck was broken. In other words, he was probably struck by something or someone. Yes, the distance of that possibility. And yet no weapon's been found though. Presumably Darkra kept creep behind Kazuma and deal the death penalty. I suppose it's possible that he had fallen and hit his head awkwardly. And with a terrible act that he would break his neck completely by accident. Oh yes, if Balfour could explain it, it's rather hard to believe Kazuma though. He wasn't a clumsy man. Well, need to fix the detective stuff.
Yes!
firmly visible next to the victim's body is a shoe polish. A shoe polish. Indeed, positively identifying analysis of construction. No matter. Beeswax total and dye result in a mix of ingredients of shoe polish. And the color of the shoe polish matches the color of Soggy's lace leather shoes. Looking at this mark, it's not hard to imagine what happened. For some reason, a Soggy must have caught his foot by some point in the foreign trip. Please, no. And by the fortune, caught his neck against something, a movable object, and fell on the floor. Covering available on this. Oh. I don't know. That really turned us full of all. What about the evidence left at the scene where I was on? Yes, the fact is clear as day to me. You know, there's clearly evidence. But there's a voluntary glare of betrayal hiding in the place you choose. It's not it. I don't believe it. Kazuma is merely tripped over and not how he's more. No, it can't be true. I refuse to accept it. It's hard to believe what the mark on the forehead seems to suggest that's what happened, but. And part of Mr. Solms' deduction is right. Miss Bobola is trying to hide some evidence that would prove it. And that cabin, somewhere directly she's caught her eye. I wonder where. That's a good point. Must be somewhere. And there wasn't a snake after all. No, oh, that little kitten is called Darkest. It seems a little. I don't. Either that or it's scratching her hand to pieces. Point is, where has it gotten to? Somebody appears to have dropped a $2,000. Yeah. It hasn't been dropped now, Rosan. It's been placed. I'm starting to sound like Mr. Shawn. Stop trying to sound like the Great Detective. The waste paper basket. Perhaps it's the first class cabin then. But Miss Barbamon occupied the cake late that night. Presumably, not much rubble is left here. Hello! Isn't it? Yes, that's it. I think I've seen that before. Look, familiar? If it looks familiar, then mine. That's right. Your evidence is linked to you, the victim of that. Ah! And the balance of a broken piece on. See, two pieces fit together. Thomas Ballone, shall we consider the intelligence? What would it be part of the glass object was evidently broken? Single victim's mind. Should it be found in the waste pass? You're well acquainted with this glass bowl, are you not? It belongs to our cat. I don't know. Oh, and that hushed Russian accent of yours won't save you, girl. Because we've concluded evidence linking to the question. What? Take it away, Mr. Noah. Yes. Yep.
Yes!
It looks like if you look at this photo, you clearly see hanging from the darkest collar is the very glass in question. There, truth is caught up with you, Miss Fall. Your young man lost his life and life also truly saw his fall. And the cause of the fatal stumble was from your cat. It was your absent feline, Dark Eye. I couldn't tell anyone. I'm sorry. Really? Okay, that has to be one of the most silly and stupid things. Why didn't you tell us now, Miss Barbara? You tell us exactly what happened last night. It was a little after 1 a.m. It was so late, but I hadn't had time to feed, so I gave her some food. And now, then all of a sudden, she scratched me and jumped out of my hands. People do say cats become very anxious and very nervous over in new environments. She was so fast, she disappeared through the ventilator. I could stop her. And that's how you acquired, rather nasty wound on the back of your hand, take it. Yes, all I had to read the rules on the wall, and I knew I was allowed to dark me. Yes, modern science suggests that animals can carry infectious disease. It's a precaution, really. So listen, trying to hear if there are some noises in the next cabin. It was very quiet. I was sure if someone was there, he would be sleeping. So that's the point you died to try to save the lure to get back. By dangling the toy through the ventilator running. Darkwire always loves this toy. But it didn't work. Nothing worked. I tried her favorite toy. I tried whistling to her. But nothing. She didn't return. So hang whistling, that's because I'm a... Cat had presently remained hidden in the shadows, but frightened. And yes, there was nothing else I could do. I just had to wait until she calmed down. But then... I nearly passed out with shock. I heard a cry out, then, such a dreadful bang. And afterwards, nothing. The total silence. Kazuma was. The final appearance of the broken on the floor. It seems like you heard the victim sleeping, having on the glass bell, then tripping. Yes, this barrel is a large vessel. Even she can pitch and roll violently without warning. If Mr. Augustine was already off balance as a result of the ship lurching when the kitten made contact with his feet, the combination of unexpected factors could easily have caused him to fall over. There's something else. But what became of the kitten afterwards? In the end, I managed to get her to come back through the ventilator. Yet, Darkon's nowhere to see. I must have forgotten to lock my case. Now she's disappeared again. Gracious, that cat's insufferable, restless as I am. Oh, he knows something about himself at least. Touche! When I woke up this morning, I heard a young man in the cabinet and next one had died. I couldn't bring myself to tell anyone that had happened. It was too scared. Scared that they would find Simi back. Oh, hold on a moment. What about the snake? Alright, where is it? The snake isn't your friend. Miss Ravona, then whose is it that came from? What on earth is such a dangerous creature on the ship? It's his! Oh, I didn't say. The snake is my friend. His name is Pavosko. What? That snake belongs to you. He escaped from his cage when the emergency alarm sounded, so I was looking for him. I didn't expect to find him here. Dad, how did he manage to get in the cage? What? Animals aren't permitted on board. You are at sea for 1 year. You want to leave so long that your close friends are without someone looking to understand? Couldn't you find someone a little more human who understands you better? But, my dear, really, Hirello. Like, surely you can appreciate the dangers you're putting your walls in. No venom. Pavosia does have venom. He's harmless, very long and gentle. He's adorable. It's venomless. Yes. You know, he's hungry. He's been in a bad mood for once I fed him. You'll see him and you eat him what, Mike? Like that, like milk, chicken, ridiculous. They drink only stupid his mouse, big fat, and mouses. So, is that the mouse traps in the passageway out there for? Of course. What else can I... Nothing to say top of the food chain. If I refuse to drink milk, I can't hear the whistle. If I can't hear climb the bell cord, I'm gonna... It's not leaving the easy on you. How dare you... It's not my fault. I did not make up stories. My father does nothing... That's nothing with his innocence. It. So that's what happened. That's the truth behind my best friend's tragic death. There's still more I have to think of. This far along? I understand the difficulty situation you found yourself in, and I do sympathize. But please remember this. A young man lost his life, and if you're going to cover up your guilt, lies then. There's no matter what the service I cannot forgive you. What? What are you talking about? What lies? It was just a series of unfortunate events, an accident. I'm not a great detective, like Mr. Lund, but I do have a gift for knowing the truth. But even not, I said, that was not the truth. Don't you agree, Mr. Nakamura? To be perfectly honest, yes. There's a discrepancy in this story, and I just can't. I confess, I was intending in Scotland to deal with any outstanding issues on this matter. Oh? I only presented here a very specific for a very. The truth is, you, Mr. Naruto, are you simply a distraction. If you're not able to finding the finding your shadow goes too uncomfortable. Not again. Where did it? I suppose since your arrest are a result of my invention, I was rather hoping that I could resolve the matters before we made it past our next port call. You were Mr. Sholmes. Yes, but I overlooked one important detail. The deceased young man was clearly a companion of yours. He was not. Was he not? Yes. But someone was the closest friend of mine. I owed him my freedom, even my freedom. In that case, we must follow the conclusion. No further distractions. You must uncover the real truth here, Mr. Naruto. Yes, whatever it may be. The key to this discrepancy in Miss Bobo's story, I'm sure. If I can chase that down, I may have covered the truth clear. That's about how we really died. About the scene in your cabin may become. Alright, I'm ready. I think it's the writing that she made. Thank you. Okay. So, yes. So we should pop on her first. Lost his life to the cabinet was bolted shut from inside. Was a truly unfortunate incident? Or was it no accident at all? That we must establish first. Well, we already established, haven't we?
Hold it!
Hey. Let's take a step. That's my sense. It really, what happened, does it? I'm going to have to ask you to spell out for me. Yes, I'm starting to shape and take it. It's a clear confirmation of the fact that Miss Barlow is right in here. It was right here in the and then I. Really? I saw it. It was a frozen. Clearing a record in the phone. There's no way I saw him with left this message on the floor. The script, it's Russian, isn't it? Indeed, it is. Words written means wardrobe. What does that? I see what it means. Most people do that in message their native language in case. But me, it's my. Adding a civilian. That's actually not the point. It's the difference is whether he knew Russia or not. Sorry? What do you mean? Exactly as I said before. There's no way Mr. Asagi would have left that message on the floor. And the reason why? It's clearly explained here. Damage to the cervical vertebrae resulting in instant death. Instant death. which means after the victim fell on the floor, he could not possibly have written anything. He was already dead. That's not only reason, the only reason, either. There's something else that we found in Mr. Asagi's cabin. A remnant of something that couldn't possibly have been there. If what must be true. What? So. Alright, setting a save here, because I have no idea. I completely forgot. Okay, I'm trying to figure it out. I'm not... Or perhaps the present is something you wanted. What am I missing? Maybe this?
Yes!
Try this again. I completely forgot, because that was a while ago.
Yes!
Nope. Again, this is Blaine, and I'm not gonna take go into
Yes. 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 Yes!
I have options here.
Yes!
Did I miss something?
Yes!
There's something...
Yes!
What is it? Yeah, I don't know. Yeah, because it just shows the everything, because it's gonna just go to the same thing. Is it? This piece of broken glass on mark on the floor. That's it. It had to be it. But that's a glass bell. Yeah, we already know about that. If a broken half is stripped over the flat itself, very satisfactorily explains the words of one that log. Unfortunately, there's very a beetle flaw. What? If that's really happened. How did the other half of the bell end up in the back of the cavern? Yes. Remember, we found the other half of the glass of the vase in the waste paper basket. Would you care to explain that, Miss Paula? Oh no. All those pieces of evidence clearly are the same conclusion. That Mr. Vasagi died in the night of this cavern. There's someone else in the room. And some person deliberately arranged the scene as the trip in order to cover up our own guilt. There was someone else present in the room.
Hold it!
Why is your tongue? Someone else was there to die. Of course we know that. What are they talking about? Well, my hand was bolted shut from it. There's no way out. Oh, yes.
Yes! Well,
if that's true, I was in the cabin when it happened. Where you're shut in the wardrobe for size and detail. I don't know Russian. There's no way I would have known that last year. Not would have. There's no way you could have. Unless it's to be precise about the details. What do you have in mind? Oh boy. Forgive me, my dear fellow. As I was saying. First thing, the question about the word wardrobe in Russian on the floor. And attempting to incriminate me for the crime, even though I've been asleep in the entire time. And then, the same person picked up the broken glass bell and fallen on the floor. For it becoming evidence to show how it really died. But how would this person have taken the piece of the bell away? Leaving half of the piece behind with rising Weston. It's past 1 o'clock, in the early hour. It could have been quite dark. A single small lamp surrounding the ceiling could have barely caused any light in the room for him. Less little wonder then the culprit failed to notice a fragment of the... You all suspect me. You don't... Oh boy, this guy. Sorry, I see him. I want to see. She's the daughter of a strong sailor. 2 years ago, they noticed her dancing skills and she went to join the ballet company. But before she was a dancer on this ship, I remember the ship's band. You don't accuse the ship's angel of being criminal. There. Well, it's almost interesting. And why would you give your tooth to pray? Hey, how it could be shook? Are you right? You are right. You should know. Nobody could enter the cabin right now. Not anyone. I know you want to tell me the killer can walk through the door. He's fine. Oh wait, I read about the it's not working, Mac. That's not working. Certainly not. Those were the late doors. Locked doors. How could you set that? 3 months ago. has a valid point that Ben is involved. Not necessarily. What? But apparently, the vault door and cabin door. Without laying a finger. And a trace of the method I have in mind having been used to before. I don't believe it. Well, Mr. Naruto, I believe you have a number in a way to fuck. One way to spring the mind? Yes. Do you really know what Mr. Shaw means, Mesma? And yes, and you should know, shouldn't you? Because we've seen it happen. Indeed, we have. So, care to be honest, Mesma? But, top of lore. Yeah, that must have happened when the ship made its emergency stop before. Yes, that's right. It's a very powerful vessel after all. When the engine stopped in reverse, a violent jolt came across the ship. I believe, yes, it is known as force of inertia. Acting as an is there nothing someone doesn't know? Or is it her book, at least? Well, whatever it's called, the same force can also be looking for, also has something in the cabinet move. The bolt door on the cabinet. Ah, it was a very obviously the emergency stop that the main ship made rather early. Came across the cabin not before we had to bolt the door. That then. Hello, is anybody there? Oh, that sounds like Inspector Hasanaya. Oh, yes. That's it. That's when the ship suddenly, the bolt flew across the door lock. Yes, it's made of metal, but the small light enough to move suddenly. One force of inertia, Neptia, if you want to call it that. Are you trying to say that last night, Mizora was killed? This morning, I look around, and I thought it looked a little odd. All the books on the shelves topple over, and the ornament, all the ornaments. It's almost as if someone had run their hands across the shelves deliberately to knock them. Oh yes, I remember that. I stood up against all them, didn't I? And when we came back to the cabin, we verified the same thing there. The books, every one of them topped over, just like Miss Arasaki. Oh my. Do you have anything to say about this, Mr. Vovova? Oh yeah, everyone, are you? It doesn't seem far-fetched, does seem a little far-fetched. Oh, is it simple enough? Are you forgetting about the button in the passageway outside? Used to trigger the emergency alarm? Oh yeah, of course. There was a noise, wasn't there, telling you only press the button on time of emergency. On a dark night, the fog. That's what. Is almost compelled to press see my one's curiosity. Wait, it was you. The button is pressed, two things happens in the interesting scene of safety. The emergency alarm bell and the vessel comes to a complete stop. And in, as indeed, it little did it earlier today. You're the one who pressed that day. Mr. Soames, surely it wasn't you who... I will always say, a button has a preferred so don't lie. He's back. How dare you mess my job? Oh no, I'm sure I'll wait until later. Must now learn a valuable lesson. The vessel is making an emergency stop. The bolt cabinet door closed. So, what we must consider... Yes, it all comes down to one thing now. Last night, after what happened, Mr. Asagi... The chef made an emergency stop, so... Or did not. It's a boat that may have many passengers. If we emerged some in the middle of the night, there would be chaos everywhere. What are your thoughts, Mr. Harmo? Well, it's certainly possible that some kind of emergency happened last night. We have evidence to support that idea. Really? What evidence, Mr. Fascinating. Do show us, good man. Some emergency. Samuel Roswell, is your duty to patrol the first class area of the ship, isn't that right? Duh. That's correct. Why? And the ship's locked here. There would be where you record detail your duty. What are you doing with that? That's why. Ah, you rather curiously left it atop of a little makeshift bureau in the passageway out there. By responsibility of passenger, we took it our care to mind by turning healer. I left it on there on purpose. There would, that's where it's always put. That point is, looking at your usual records, it's clearly under normal circumstances. You write the phrase nothing to report every 30 minutes. But 2 o'clock last night, lights and first light this morning, nothing was recorded at all. Nothing was recorded in the log. That is the... Because nothing happened. Because nothing happened, you normally write nothing to report, wouldn't you? Indeed so, which tells us shortly after 2 a.m. nothing happened. Our board the SS Bureau. Something significant to make you forget that the ship's log... Log in fact. I'm suggesting that the ship really did make an emergency stop in the middle of the night. That's fucking rubbish. I'm perfectly honest, I had a little hard to believe in myself. Oh, why? Well, because something major really happened. Surely all of us would notice. That's very true. It's an emergency stop we expected earlier. The ship lurched so violently and the alarm bells were so loud. I couldn't imagine anybody sleep through that, even if it happened then. Oh no, that's not a good point. Everybody's headache! But the throbbing. Sorry? What do you mean? Your headache. Man, the throbbing of your head since this morning, we've all suffered with it. Ah! Oh, yes, I heard that. Right, you're right. In fact, I haven't felt this way since I woke up today. No, have I. I have been heavy ever since I laid down. On. Have you affected? Having you all been affected? He's right, my head's been throbbing too. And since eating dinner yesterday evening, everything has felt sort of hazy. I can't really remember anything that happened. And then the first thing I noticed in the morning was the throbbing pain in my head. I had already been dragged out of that wardrobe in hands and cuffs. Tell me, Mr. Murder. You boarded a vessel as a subway, didn't you? Oh, yes. Sorry. The subway class accommodation doesn't usually include meals. What did you survive on? Well, Kazuma looked after me. He was always happy to share his meals. So you enjoyed some meal, wholesome roast chicken dish that served yesterday evening, didn't take it? Yes. In fact, I had all of it. Kazuma wasn't fond of chicken. Oh, really? So the victim didn't eat any chicken at all. That's right. He didn't touch it. Is it really that relevant? My dear fellow, does that strike you? Oh, Mr. Solms, do you mean to say that there's something wrong with the chicken? I do. No, really. The prepare for the passengers last night have been tampered with. Tampered with by an additional spavastic designed and deduced leave somewhere for those who consume it. A sleeping drug. Do you mean whoever did lace the sleeping drug was so no one would notice the ship's emergency stop? That's an Naruto. Of course, that's not what Mr. Song means. What far-fetched idea? Precisely. I see the meal every passenger is bored with a sporadic drug would certainly be impossible. Unless, that is, every single member of the crew wasn't a conspirator. What? Mr. Sholmes. Well, seaman. I'm sorry to say, but the more description in this matter, you got nowhere. You nowhere. If you refuse to talk, there will have to be an inquiry that made through the shipping company, of course. And we're here to have that happen. The member of the crew and the captain himself will be handed over to the Coles. For aiding and abetting a renegade. Please, no more. I will tell you how. I can't make problems like this. Remember more. Those crewmen are your former comrades, I believe. Yes, so when I decided to run away, I asked them to help me. He agreed to help everyone together. She threw away everything. Her fame, her ballet in the ballet, Mother Russia. We wanted to help our angel. I don't believe it. You are right. We put sleeping drug in the chicken last night. Yes, I remember now. I did notice chewing on a lump of something strange, a bitter and poignant. We could not make all the drug. How do you say dissolve? Ugh. Talk about the heavy seasoning. You could have seasoned it a lot, I'm just saying. At midnight, the waiter, ordered near Shanghai, we brought our angel aboard. She helped us by comrades ashore with small fishing boat. While all the passengers on SS Bora were sleeping soundly. Thanks to almost a magnificent effect of a slumber of inducing potion, their evening meals have combined. So that's why. Like last night, where the crew who people dislike the chicken and newly boarded. That means it was a possibility for you. You couldn't have emergency. How did it make sense? Surely everyone in the capital would end up locked in their that in case there would have been a complete chaos. Oh, I wouldn't say so. What? Of course. Just like us, the other passengers would have eaten their evening meal of chicken in the cabinets. After which, they would have been overwhelmed by the tiredness because of the sleeping flight. And accordingly, all passengers were already in their cabins at the night. Yes. The only majority of the passengers would happen to sleep in their cabins. Doors bolted anyway. So none of them would have found it remarkable to find the doors locked in the morning. Summary, in order to fasten the bolt, the single cabin in the door ship, the culprit must have used the vessel as emergency up in the early hours in the morning. You have talked a long time, said many things. What's the point? The point is what I said earlier. There was someone else present at the scene when the victim lost his life that night. Someone left a message in Russian in the attempt to accommodate another. Someone who tried desperately to hide the broken fragment in the glass revealed the culprit's true identity. And someone observed the ship, abused the ship's appraisal. All I told by night, by busy night. What? I don't know anything about this. I'm just a, I like this feeling. Honestly, I don't listen to long, boring stories. You know, stories like me, only trust. I laugh a whole straight. What? I'm quite the same disposition as my good man. And observation to me, everything. Is that right? Oh, yes. You hear it? The accusations cry of guilt in the wind. What? I can't hear you cry of guilt. Sorry, you. Oh. What? No, your assistance, please. What exactly, Mr. Solms? My dear Rel, I said there are two investigators. Observation. If you remember, Mr. Nardo, we knew about that somebody tried to fabricate evidence, don't we? I tapped in the scene with my son's death. So. What are we looking for? A trace of evidence of that one was on there when it happened. Precisely. Delightful, quick gasp on the meme. Alright, let's see what I can do. A trace of evidence that shows someone was in late last summer. There we go. the salmon swallow. You seem to have quite a large purple stain on your back when you... What? Yes, I don't know where that dart came from. Oh, so nothing in particular mind about the stain. That was my... Why are you talking about it, I say? I'd be curious because snippets of this thing has escaped your fatal your attention, Seaman. Allow us to explain. A very large portion of the stain on Seaman's back in the uniform. And what made it perfectly clear? Indeed it is. Will Mr. Noble present evidence that proves it? My pleasure. Alright then, evidence that proves the stain on the... Yes. Yes. It's a photograph in the ink, and it shows what caused the stain. Ink. Our usual color ink, purple. The panel at last seems you see the significance. The Russian word on the floor of the victim's body is written in purple ink. The stain on your back and your ink is exactly the same color. And the ink has been dried up. It could possibly have stained your uniform, by the way. Which means... must have a present in the cabinet in the moments immediately after the ink was spilled. Alright, yes. It was me. I did it. Everything. I arranged everything. Instead... I feel like the wardrobe man did it. I presented the... I did everything noise. Shh. Beth, please. Don't worry, Angel. Let me do this on you. Through the ventilation, then he tripped and broke his neck and fell on the floor. Yes, that's right. There's something about that. When the cat ran away, Mr. Waller visited the cabin next to hers, only to find the ogre lifeless on the floor. There's something else that's suspicious, I'm not gonna lie. She only opened to look. You already know what happened after it. There's just one thing you wouldn't want. What? Was he already dead? Why? I told you. Floor, not moving, and I was scared. There's something off about it. I understand, and I believe you, but I don't believe. So this finally is over. Yeah. Have they discovered the real truth about Kusama's death at last? Something very nearly slipped my mind. Oh, Mr. Solms. Perhaps this photograph. Yes, it looks like... Look at yourself, you know? The cause of death was a broken neck, therefore the victim died instantaneously. Unfortunately, the incident that participated in can stumble. However, if there are facts, there is one particular area in the photograph. That seems unnatural. Oh, the hallmark right there. What do you mean, unnatural? What are your thoughts on the matter, Arsene? I want to finish this case up before we get on, before we end this. Very true. It's certainly particular. I mean, my answer, I'm sorry. The particular case detail orchestrated by the culprit. I mean, the identity point. The identity point, another point. Oh, I see. Imagine, if you will, losing your footing in yourself. In your opinion, you landed on the victim, as the victim appears to have done here. It would have been almost unnatural. I'm sure it would just seem... How thoughtful you are, Mr. Sol. Thank you, Bert. If Kama Sima tripped and fell, oh, by something terrible, stroke of bad luck, broke his neck, this part of the photograph seems unnatural. The fist doesn't seem quite right. That exactly the same thought occurred to me. If I fall unconscious, I'm gonna fall flat. Yeah, you see here, the victim, with his left hand tightly balled up in the fist. And also, like you see, though he was gripping something. What do you mean? Simply, if I don't know, I took his liberty. You did. Well, can I find her? Your health? Mr. Sholmes. Show us, wise. Of course, why, dear man. Why do you keep this? This was how I found. Oh, a crescent moon! Yeah, in the middle. Yes, you're right, a crescent moon. That's what I tell you. Oh, but that's not. It's not sure the crescent and a crescent moon looks like a familiar somehow. That's pretty sure. Observation. Oh, that's the key. What? The truth is fascinating close. How did the crescent moon come weave in Cosanelli's clenches? The final clue, the last piece of the puzzle. All yours, and the crescent moon meant, what's the difference without it? Observe. There it is. What is that? There's something dangling from her ear. Yes, that's airing. Wait, look. A crescent moon is open. Oh, that could be Dallas. Miss Marvel, on your right ear. On your left ear. You have a crescent moon as well. Ah! What? And your other ear? Yep. And we found the victims. Clearly. Do you agree, Mr. Noble? Yes. As for all, as I saw, you must have grasped up that person and grasped it all before he fell to the floor. In other words, last night, Mr. Soggy's cabin, you witnessed the moment the victim fell on your eyes. You were quite literally at the arm's length of it. But the question is, why did Mr. Asagi do that? Why did he pull his earring from her ear to hold the clenched in the moment? Oh no. Evil. No one can protect you now. This might as well tell us the truth. And last night, what did he do? I think about everything that happened yesterday. It was too much. Running away, the fishing boat, and trying to climb the huge ship onto the huge ship, and then I was at least in the cabin. I could relax in the horrible after this horrible day. Dark. Wait. I couldn't believe it when she disappeared through the ventilator. I tried to call her with a little whistle.
tried everything, waving her favorite toy, but nothing worked. Darko would not come back.
What are you doing here at this time of night, Inspector? Oh. I'm sorry. I thought it was a friend. It was a friend of mine. A little man from your country. He was very polite and kind. He helped me find Darkwa, and he promised not to tell anyone. But then he had my friend, and I was going to leave a man. Yes. I'm sure I know your face. I've seen you somewhere before. Ah, of course. You're a nickel and a bubble, aren't you? Rest of my life. I don't know that. I nearly stopped when he said that. He knew who I was. How could this man from a land far away use no? Yes, I saw your performance in Japan. But what are you doing on this ship? I'm sorry. I can't fool him. I have to tell him the truth and hope he doesn't tell anyone. I had no other choice. Yes. I see. So you run away. Please. Give me a moment. I could use another. He wasn't. He was gonna ask you. On duty and fast away. And then on the phone. She was there. I believe she. Please, I have nowhere else to go. So you decide to help. And so no one suspected the passenger in the cabinet the next day. Yes. I went to the cabin to look around to make sure there was nothing to show Nina was there. Then I found the girl stole it, and the wardrobe still sleeping. Right, that was a... So you worked out a plan to blame on the stowaway. I closed the wardrobe door and put back the paper sign. Luckily for me, there's only one reason someone started to believe in me. Sato-san, and I tried to get his body to a good place and use the ink. What's this difference? And tell me, what's the blast spell? Was by my feet. I picked it up. I see. But it was dark in the cabin. I didn't notice the other half. The angel went back to our cabin. I finished the job by pressing the office. Yes. Of Accordingly, the SS Railroad did not come to an end until the emergency door. Thus, enticing the bolt, cabin door shut and locked. There's still one thing I don't understand, Miss Pavlova. What? Well, you said you were runaway, and it has become the worry that you were going to try to... that you punished some. Isn't that right? Yes. But even if they had pulled the bell cord, they called for the captain of the ship. Aren't your friends with every member of the crew? Why would they have been a problem? It was as if he said first, that made me see what he said first. What are you doing at this time of night, Inspector? Oh, I'm sorry. Is that an inspector? His first one. Yes. Who was supposed to be? I thought if the police knew about me, I would be in arrest. May I stop you from it, please, Miss Paula? Doesn't seem to make sense. I mean, Mr. Asagi really was gonna hold a ball cord? I don't know. What do you think, Mr. Nardo? Well, I can't know for certain, but he was a man of his word. If he told you he wasn't gonna give a secret, then he wouldn't have done. Well, he was talking all the way through it. He was... Oh, Mr. Naruto. The day of the... See, there's one with the... What? The other... Yes, what action was the victim really about to take at the moment? To determine whether the young man's gaze was directed. The first concerned the victim location. Yes. Well, I have to change my mind. Yes, exactly as it was. Are you ready then? No. Yes. There's only one thing I learned today, that there's simply a gaze that reveals the truth. And that only in order is to draw the right conclusion. You can tip forward as well. So. He was looking at here. The wardrobe. Considering everything that happened last night, certainly may look like Kazuma was a doorbell. Yes, however, right directly beside the bell cord was the wardrobe. The wardrobe. And more importantly, what was inside the wardrobe? The man's great friend, sleeping soundly. Miss Farmer, please think back carefully. What were exact words last night? Wait a sec, I can use another opinion here. Another opinion? Yep. Not for a member of the crew. No, for Miss Ayut. To see if it's between them, I'm able to help in some way, no doubt. Oh no. It was an accident. Not I wish you had made sure Mr. Arthur was looking at. The thing may have ended differently if you had. I wanted to thank you for finally admitting the truth. But unfortunately, the truth is the man lost his life because of what he did. And that will never change. I hope you'll never forget that. I'm sorry. She could have escaped easily without consequence. If she just let that happen. It's all at long last. The mystery surrounding the tragic accident of the SS Bowery was finally laid to rest. That's sad. And tragic. What will happen to Miss Barbara now? Once every script written, she'll be handed over to the police of at Scottish Hall. What about the fact that she ran away from Russia? Won't Russia try to reparate her? Apparently, the English detective can speak to the immigration office to sort that out. Mr. Solms, huh? She won't be going back to Russia then. No, I don't think so. Even if she wanted to return in the future, I doubt she would be able to. She ran away. So now she's exiled for life. I see. I'm sorry. See my song about. I wanted to help our angel, no matter what. But I didn't think about you, about how you lost your girlfriend. I will go with Nina. I'll give myself to the register. That's kind of you. In the meantime, thank you for letting me go free again. Because of us, that feels such a great waste, but... Well, do what you can for Miss Barbara. Won't you? No. Well, I'm afraid you need to pack now. We're due to arrive in Hong Kong tomorrow. As much as it pains me, I'm going to have to hand you over to the consul to arrange a passage back to Japan. Yes, I was. So, you should get back to your cabin now. It looks like my study to Great Britain, is over, even if to think the only day ago Kazuma and I were laughing together, we tear up the streets in London. Some distant memory now. Seems like a distant. Oh, what's that? It's something we. Such as a sign. I don't think I have. Well. It's been a long time. Inspector Hassanay told me I should pack. You really ready to leave the ship tomorrow at all? Oh, what? I still can't believe this happened. I can't believe someone's life can be over. Like that. Sato-san. Yeah, such a great idea to visit Great Britain. So many dreams. And now, it's coolly been taken away. Just as he was. As. I thought I could never forgive the person responsible. And now, Now we know the truth. It was just an accident. It's a silly, serious mishap. It's too much, number of son. Just too much. Yeah, I know. I wish there was something I could say. Inspector, my duty was to see, Asagi-san, his great safety, the great friend. I failed. It caused two of his closest friends great pain and suffering as a result. I left everyone down. And, well, anything to make up for my terrible blunder. Nobody blames you, Inspector. Ugh. And I'm free to go again now, at least. Really? Surprise, man. What does it mean, this? Oh, trifling matter. Simply in my head, I should say. Well, then. The middle of it all. Sorry. So I said I was sorry to you. You are sorry. He thinks it's funny. Mr. Sholmes, we do appreciate your assistance. I could thank you from the bottom of our heart. Oh, not at all. And though it's a little late, may I offer my sincere condolences. The loss of your companion is truly heartbreaking. I hope that you will be able to heartfelt some of his operations in this honor. I'm afraid that won't be possible. We shall disembark the next port in Hong Kong. We have to return to Japan and make a full report of everything that happened. Wait a minute. Is it just me that has to go back, isn't it? I mean, I was the stowaway. The terms of the study tour were negotiated by the Britain's Department of Justice of Great Britain and Japan. It'd be one lawyer and one assistant. I see. In light of Mr. Sawyer's enforced of that, I'm afraid that the tour can no longer go ahead. Oh no, I don't care. My dear fellows, one of the problems have a extremely simple solution, you know. All you require is one lawyer and the study tour. You can continue. There's no one else that can possibly qualify for Mr. Holmes. No one has a lot of qualifications, you say. Quite frankly, obtaining your country will be a little value of Great Britain, I'm afraid. Oh, but anyway, the voyage to London still promised a good month of time. Ample opportunity, I'd say, to find yourself another suitable lawyer. Yes. Miss Soto? Yes? Do you think perhaps I might be able to do it? You're not a lawyer, Miss Soto. Oh, unless you're studying the law. No, I'm not, but I'm sorry, but in that case, I don't see. But as I said, there's still one more. Isn't that right, Mr. Morrow? Yes, I have a month of voice to study, to learn what I mean, come on, wait, learn. Mr. Naruto, that's ridiculous. Are you suggesting anybody can learn all that in 40 days? There's only one way to find out. I work my fingers to the bone, Inspector, every day, single day. So will you let me try and I was screaming, I haven't learned enough to recognize as a lawyer. I'll take whatever punishment deemed appropriate. But why put yourself through a difficult position for Cosima? You said that there was something he had to do in Great Britain. and he would sacrifice anything to make it happen. He was passionate about it. I can't let all his passion just come to nothing. Anyway, for our own benefits too, I will become a lawyer. I have to. What do you say, Mr. Sosato? I think it's a wonderful idea. Thank you. So, what are your effective plans say? Are you serious? One lawyer, one assistant. The numbers are indisputable. No. This is madness. Yeah, fascinating, wouldn't you agree? Fascinating. Greed and rules are dull and routine existence. Give us interest and give us fascination. Speak for yourself. Besides, all answers are no measure of a man. What makes a matter's character, no? You also forget he also defended himself in trial. And you witnessed the ample evidence of this man's assembly in your own eyes, but clearly, even early from the early hours this morning until the very moment. Despite containing the passing of his close companion, despite the accusation of guilt, this man has shown resourcefulness, intelligence, and above all, courage. Very well. I think a clever way to report the Department of Justice. Inspector. After all, I did make a promise, didn't I? I said I'd do anything to make up for the shortcomings here. Oh, thank you, Inspector. If you'll excuse me, I must pay a visit to the captain's quarters, I think. I need to discuss what to do next and how the best to make my report. And a few beatings if I had to take a guess. Are you really prepared to attempt this, Mr. Narasato? Yes, I'm going to try. I wonder, would I consider teaching me? You consider teach me everything I know about my lawyer? I wonder. I'd be delighted to help you. I am a judicial assistant, after all. Thank you. And Mr. Naruto? I'd like you to take charge of this. Me? Are you sure? Wanted? Yeah, he would've. It's named for someone's great sword. It's been Asasaga's own clan's generation. Very well. Accept the treasure. I'll try to write. It's always. Wow. I never expected this case to go this long. So then, Mr. Otato, it seems we'll be working together for some time yet. Well, be honored, Mr. Naruto. And for the next 40 days, I also grant you the same single minimum for you. Oh, you sir. That's as I want to eat. But, before we do it again, I didn't earn a favor to ask you to. What about this? What is it? Please tell me on the ground. 3 times. What? I should never have doubted you. I should have been able, obviously, to start. But I allow suspicion to get better in me. And no matter how safe I feel, I'm completely. No, you're shot. You just found out about the stowaway. He's like, Andy. No, I'm. No, it's good. Please. No, I don't. nice mission, though. It's not a skill one requires without constant training. How long are you there? Several times with a great interest. I confess, I was most impressed. Well, when did he see that? I presume that would be a form of Japanese wrestling. Oh, well, in a way, it's not wrestling, but my own inspiration, ancient jujitsu technique. Apparently, it's called a Sarasun technique. It leaves your head swimming, really. Oh, really? I am. There he goes. Okay, you're gonna regret it. Really? He had to do it on him? Really? Are you? Oh yes, arresting indeed is the term of the Sedona tank. In my groggy state of consciousness, as seen from an evening recently spent with the consumer flickering on my mind. Karama. That's right. It's probably his sword. It's been down from great Asagi clan. I can't believe you managed to get permission to bring it with you. I mean, you're taking the katana on a study tour. It's a little irregular. Surely. Absolutely that. Mm-hmm. In the name of compelling, we'll slice evil in two. Now that would you need more compelling? Much more compelling? On that side. There's something very important that I have to do. Even the Great Britain. Sacrifice anything to make it happen. Apparently, I appreciate you seeing through. Well, of course. Well, whatever it is, I'll see you through to the end. I knew you would want. The most important thing he had to do is I still don't know what was. But I'm going to see a place for myself and work it out. In Great Britain's capital, London. And that's case, that's chapter 2, or the second tournament. A great cruising, candidate. Alright, that is the Adventures of the Unmarkable Spectral Band.
Okay, final thoughts on this case. If you ask me, second cases aside from turn have been hit or miss throughout the franchise. You got the stolen Turner Bell from Chase 2, which was really good. I'm not gonna lie, Turner Bell Sisters was not really much my favorite it because of how the way you ended it. Even though I do find the villain really good. Reunion of Turnabout was really good. And we do not dare talk about the Turnabout of the Corner. No Ace Attorney fan talks about that. Even if I did enjoy Apollo Justice. After that point, the second turnabouts after that point, after Apollo Trials and Tribulations, pretty much went downhill, in my opinion. The best turnabout Airlines is probably my least favorite case, of all of them. And the one in Spirit of Justice really could have been done better, in my opinion. But this one, it was not bad. Though I kind of figured most of it out, when the mention of the black of the cat, the animal, to be honest. The case is fun, it's fine, and it's not bad for a second case. Base. As for the first case, I have to talk about it anyway. It's actually not because I didn't get a chance to talk about it last time. It's a great way to start off your tutorial, but I wish it wasn't that long, to be honest. I do understand, but it was kind of really hard to deduce a lot of these things, including what happened in case two. But that said, so far I'm enjoying this game. It just as so far. Next time we'll be starting the next turnabout slash chapter 3, the adventure of the runaway room. I'm MGunnels3. I'll catch you guys tomorrow. I'm heading to bed.